Do you see maybe Kill Switch Engage in the future incorporate more experimental stuff in the music, or is it more like a small box where it's not many place for other experimentation?
Well, we're the kind of guys that always think outside the box, but at the same time with the metal genre, it's always kind of have to gotta kick ass, you know, and just be aggressive, and you know, so yeah, it's definitely a leniency we have with it, but at the same time, you know, we try to make it sure it's still energized and exciting to listen to, yeah.
Because I think Howard, the vocalist, has a very soulful vocal actually for a metal band.
He's black.
Yeah, I didn't want to go into stereotypes, but maybe you named it yourself now. And do you think also the playing, his voice changed the playing a little bit?
Well, yeah, I think once we got Howard, it opened up a whole different, you know, window of just possibilities with vocal arrangements. And he's a very, very gifted singer. Like, his pitch, his timbre is fantastic. You know, you can tell he's actually very good at what he does. And it's made it very easy for us. And it's been a blessing to have him in the band, yeah.
Okay, that's good. You also have a, there he is actually now. You also have a career, so to say, or as a producer, and you stated you want to produce more also in the future for third party bands. Yeah. Is that, do you also, when you produce a new Killswitch Engage, or you write music for it, is it hard for you to separate those two progressions?
Yeah, it's very hard. Well, the problem is, it's like you're producing and you're trying to make the best record you want to, but at the same time, it's like your child, it's your baby, so you care a little too much, so it gets a little crazy in your head, you know, it's just, you get kind of get tripped over yourself, you know.
So. Okay. Because you also had some, commercial success, commercial success with chart hits in America, and also made a soundtrack for Resident Evil, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
And maybe already you are also part of the Guitar Hero computer game.
Yeah.
Is there, did you also reach new people with that, or did you get some strange reactions doing that?
No, it's all been really positive. We're really excited about everything, every opportunity we've been given. It's been amazing. We've had a really great run, and I think that's a state of mind of where everybody in the band is at right now, because it's like these couple shows that we're doing right now are pretty much the last few shows we're doing before we go home to write a new record. And we've had a couple of years straight up just touring, and really awesome things have been happening. We really are so thankful for every opportunity we've been given, and that was a big part of it. It was just, it's awesome. You know?
Because it's maybe adds a whole new dimension to being in a band, because it's like very integrated with a lot of new media stuff. And do you have someone or who in the band overlooks this new progression? And maybe when you start writing now also, will it affect the writing a little bit, or you maybe there are some new chances coming up there?
I don't think it'll affect the writing. I just think it's something that's very cool. That's really it's been very helpful to us. It's been nice, you know.
But are there also things, maybe an example you can think of that you would definitely not do to lend your music to?
Playing this early today. Everybody walked on stage like, hungover, drank too much. Throat is killing me.
Not a no beer policy, so it's you're definitely not a straight edge band then, probably, or
no, farthest thing from it.
Yeah. But I think then these kind of shows, they're tired.
We spent last night in Amsterdam, so there you go.
Okay, so you had the double. Can we see this maybe as a little vacation then for the band as well?
Sorry?
This maybe then a little vacation vibe you have here for the band now as well?
Well, you know, we do our thing, you know, it's all good.
Because how full-time is...